Deputy John Halligan, 2 minutes. Deputy.
Thank you, Lascan Corla. Taoiseach, one of the most stark comments from last week's Irish Primary Principal Network conference was that teachers are encountering an increasing number of school children coming to school hungry. One in five principals surveyed reported that more pupils are turning up at school without breakfast. Taoiseach, this statement is no surprise to any of us sitting here. The country is experiencing an alarming rate of poverty levels among children. But what is frightening is the latest statistics by the CSO, released last week, which stated that a further 35,000 children have fallen into the poverty trap in Ireland. Increase in poverty, Taoiseach, has brought the problem of hungry school children to critical levels. These are not my words. These are the words of many principals who went on the airways last week to speak about this problem. And teachers across the country are reporting an increasing rise in children unable to concentrate, and an exceptional rise over the last number of years in problems with numeracy and literacy. Taoiseach, while the meals programme operated by the Department of Social Welfare is doing good, it is addressing only a fraction of the problem. Taoiseach, when I was elected, I made a promise that I would speak out and represent many people who cannot speak for themselves. There are now 270,000 children in this country suffering some degree of poverty, and I'm speaking for those in the Dáil today.
Thank you, Deputy.
And why am I doing this, having spoken about poverty in my first leader's questions? Well, anyone that went listens to the airwaves last week, a principal from Waterford, Maria Dial, could not but be shocked with what she said and what she was experiencing. And I met that principal on Monday. And I have to say, I don't easily get distressed or stressed, but I was, having spoken to her for an hour. My questions to you, Taoiseach, are that while we have former ministers and Taoiseach walking around this country, one who has abandoned the country, one minister to live in Florida on huge pensions, isn't it reprehensible, offensive and shocking when you think of the two unequals? Can I ask you, Taoiseach, based on what these principals have said and what teachers all over the country are saying, particularly in primary schools, would you consider additional supports, including a further rollout of the breakfast clubs and funding for a food element to after-school homework clubs? This is what the principals of primary schools are looking for. And my second quick question is, would you allow the setting up of a national programme of emergency food aid to cope with the rapidly increasing numbers of children going to school hungry?
Well, this is an issue that needs to be addressed. There shouldn't be any child hungry in this country. I've been in schools myself, speak to principals. A child is unable to concentrate to study or to learn properly if they're hungry. Now, in a school not too far from here, a couple of years back, where the principal took the unorthodox decision himself of involving the parents from the particular housing estates involved. And instead of children coming to school with a bottle of fizzy juice and a couple of sweets, they actually cooked breakfast for them with the mothers for a very small charge, provided a decent breakfast for every child in the school. The result was that improvement in concentration and study was self-evident. So there is a point here, Deputy, in that there will be 37 million spent on the school meal programme this year, dealing with over 192,000 children. There was a further 2 million allocated for that, which is an important consideration here. But I have to tell you that I've also had visits from parents where the wholesome sandwiches and meals are provided to some schools. And there's an immorality in dumping that every day because it's not used by lots of people. So we need to look at what's happening here. And for those who really might be hungry, the issue of of educating about better cooking, involvement with major food brands as to what they could do here, the question of an extension of the breakfast scheme, but also the waste that has been involved in some elements of this scheme over the years is not in the best interest of children, because of the amount of food supplied that is untouched and dumped. At the end of the day, there's a need for restructuring this. I know the minister is very interested in it, and from that point of view, as I say, Deputy, the fact that 37 million is being spent on it this year, which is an increase of over 2 million, which will deal with almost 200,000 children, is an issue that is obviously of concern both to the government and the department and the minister. And it is an issue that requires, constant monitoring and discussion with principals in the department, and we'll see that that happens.
Now, Deputy Halligan, you have 1 minute supplementary question.
It doesn't require constant monitoring. It requires immediate action. Now, I don't believe for one moment that you would accept that children should go to school hungry. I don't think you're that type of a person, and I know that you would know that this is the case. And we are maintaining the levels of support into schools. But the problem is there are more and more children going to school every year and more children falling into poverty. Taoiseach, I'm making an appeal to you here. Even if you were to meet the primary school principals, sit down with them and listen to what they're saying. Do you know that there are principals across the country bringing in food themselves for children? Do you know that there are people presenting themselves at soup kitchens? There's one going to open up in Donegal, Deputy Pringle tells me. And Sligo, and people are going there to get food to give to their children. What I'm asking you to do, Taoiseach, is a very simple request. If what these principals are saying is correct, and I have no doubt that it is correct, would you meet them? Would your department meet them and sit down? We're not speaking about adults here. We're speaking about the most vulnerable people in our society. Young children from the age of 5 years of age, 5, 6, 7 years of age, coming into school without breakfast and hungry. This cannot be tolerated. This cannot be tolerated by any of us here in the Dáil, irrespective as to what differences we have and how this economy, what has happened to this economy, who created the problems in this economy. The immediate problem is now that as we speak here today at 9:30, there are children coming to school at 8 o'clock in the morning before they go to school at 9 o'clock. Why? So that they might get something to
eat.
This was said on the airways last week, Taoiseach. I'm making an appeal to you. I'm not arguing with you. And I don't want to get into any big row with you over this. What I'm appealing to you to do as Taoiseach of this country, meet the principals. Meet the principals. See what they have to say. Deputy McGrath is a former principal. He will tell you. I spoke to him. He has met principals over the last number of weeks. They tell him this is happening in Ireland.
Thank you, Deputy.
We cannot tolerate this and we must bring this to an end. At least meet the principals, listen to what they have to say and do something about this. They're young children.
I call the Taoiseach. Final reply, Taoiseach.
Well, I'm not interested in having a row with you, Deputy Halligan. The point you raised is a very serious point. Any school principal in their school at this hour of the morning, they know the background and the circumstances to where there are problems here. And the problems are many-fold and they spread across a number of issues. I think it's a case, really, of being able to have a flexible scheme that can actually cater for where this arises. Now, you're aware of the sensitivity of treatment of children in schools. You don't want to have social barriers erected here or issues raised that shouldn't be raised in the interests of children. But I think it's a case of having an understanding from the principal's perspective of the background to individual problems. Now, as I said when I started to reply to your first question, the fact that children be well fed and well nourished means so much more in terms of improvement in the education standards and their concentration to be able to learn. There shouldn't be any child hungry in an Irish school in 2013. And it's a case of using the resources that are being expended here to where they're most beneficial. Now, it's not a case of meeting principals and hearing from them what you're telling me now. It's a case of being able to use the resources that are currently being spent here to best effect And this issue is one that I'll discuss with the Minister for Education, who may already have met the principals that you speak of from the group and association that you refer to.
Good morning. That concludes leaders' questions, and we now go on to the order of business.